Okay, so if you're using Google Sheets and you have a column of data like this one here on the left, if you look at it, it has leading and trailing spaces. So there's spaces before some of the letters or spaces after that you want to get rid of. I'm going to show you steps to get that done. Sometimes it's straightforward, but later on down this column, we have some that are more complicated. But if it's just a matter of getting rid of spaces that are actually someone hit the space bar or they just came in with those characters in it, it's pretty easy. So we're going to look at this first value in the column, and this is, I hit F2, and that gets me into the cell. You could also, I'm going to hit the escape key to go back, you could also click into the formula bar at the top. But I think it's easier to see if I do it by hitting F2. So I'm gonna tap F2. You can see there's a trailing space, and that's because the cursor isn't next to the H right now. If I hit the left key, it'll go and get there, but there's a space here. And there's also leading spaces because the S isn't all the way up against the edge. So there's 1, 2, 3 spaces here and a space at the end. Now I'm gonna use a formula to get rid of that. I have 2 in a row here just so you can, actually put 3 in a row, so you can see how to apply the formula to all of them easily. This formula, don't cheat and look up here, I'm going to type it in for you. Just use a trim formula, that's going to be your quickest, and that's what this is what it's designed for, is to take out the spaces. So we're going to trim B4, that's just referencing the cell where it is. Close off the parentheses. If you stop and look for a second, this box here with the blue letters is telling you what the output of the function is going to be already. So you can see it's working. Close it off and hit enter. If I go back in this box and hit F2, you see the formula's in there, not the output of the formula. What you need to do is when you're all done, I won't make you wait, I'll do it on this one so you can see, is you have to copy it and paste it as a value. Otherwise, it's always going to have to reference B4. And if the value in B4 goes away, this function won't work. So it's working now. What you would do with all of them is just copy. So I hit Control C, or you could do copy up here. But then the trick is to paste special as values. And that will take the formula out and just make it a value. I'm not going to do that right now. I want to leave the formula in here to keep showing you these different steps, but that's what you would do when you are done. So going back, if you have a column, not just one cell, but lots of them to do this for, you go down in the lower right-hand corner of this formula, and you see how your cursor just turned into a plus sign? That means that you can hold the left mouse key and drag it down. And I don't know why I didn't do it all the way down. Let's do it one more. Up to this point, this function has worked in cells C4. It worked in C5. You don't see any spaces. And it worked in 6 and 7 too. And if that works on all of your data, great. Leave it there because it's easiest. So it's easiest to maintain, right? So you just understand it's just trim. But if you go down to C8, it stops working. It's the same function, it's trim on B8, but there's a leading space that you can see right here. What is happening is that there's a non-breaking space in here. So this is a little bit different from a space, and it's just not what the trim function looks for. So the trim function is still working, but it thinks there's nothing to get rid of. If I go into cell B8, I'll show you what it looks like, but it might not come through looking like this. But it's a special character, it's character number 160, which means a non-breaking space. But you may just see Shannon Rutherford in here with a little space before it, and you don't know why it's not going away. The way to get rid of this is if we look at C9 is operating on B9, which also has non-breaking spaces. Let's go into C9, and you can see I added the substitute function. And what the substitute function does is it says, look at B9, if there's any character 160s, which is a non-breaking space, make it a regular space, substitute it with that. And then the trim comes along and gets rid of that regular space. So that's kind of the next level if you still have leading spaces. But if you're having problems, you might just want to jump to the third level. So there's three functions wrapped into a formula that should get rid of everything. That's going to be this next step. If you look at B10, I put a character in here. It just does a line break. And I picked that because it's obvious. You see something is going on there, and it's actually happening in the beginning of the cell. And I also put one in the middle. And that's a good reminder that some of these functions aren't just going to take care of things in the beginning and the end. They're also going to trim it out of the middle. So be careful. Make sure that's what you want. But to get rid of this and to get rid of anything that occurred in these previous cells, you would do these three functions. Start it off with trim, which is what we were doing before. Then parentheses and use clean, which gets rid of any ASCII non-printing characters. And these are just more remnants that can come into your spreadsheet. If you're working with data that came in from somewhere else, it can have these things in it that you want to get rid of. And so the ASCII characters, they could just be hanging out in there in data that came in from some other source, and you don't want them in there. So you clean them out with this, and then do the substitute for any non-breaking spaces. Between all three of those, it should take care of everything. And you can see I have Walt Lloyd all in one space here. You can't really tell that the beginning enter key is gone because it's bottom aligned anyway, but that's why I put one in the middle. You can see that that's gone because it's all on one line. And that should cover all the scenarios that you could have for characters that you can't see that you want to get rid of from your data and just clean it up. So I hope that was helpful.